Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I appreciate the time. I've got the Federal Reserve on my mind this morning. You can't really get through the Federal Reserve, as you know, in 5 minutes, Mr. Speaker. But I wanted to start down the road today because I saw a headline Bloomberg reported to say that what had been intended to be the beginning of an unwinding of a Federal Reserve balance sheet wasn't going to occur in the timely fashion that that had been intended. This was news to me based on what we've seen in the Budget Committee. I have with me this morning, Mr. Speaker, the Federal Reserve Act authorization. Folks often wonder where the Federal Reserve comes from. The truth is it comes from the Federal Reserve Act. I point to Section 2A Monetary Policy Objectives. It says the Board of Governors of the Federal Reserve and the Open Market Committee shall maintain long-run growth of the monetary and credit aggregates commensurate with the economy, long-run potential to increase production, so as to promote effectively the goals of maximum employment, stable prices, and moderate long-term interest rates. Now, I know there's some high school economics students out there who are thinking, hey, wait a minute, can you really promote stable prices, maximum employment, and moderate long-term interest rates with the same set of policies? I share that high school economics concern about whether or not those three goals can be pursued collectively, but this is the mandate the Federal Reserve has, and this is why the Federal Reserve is involved in what they're involved in. Now, Mr. Speaker, what I have here is the Federal Reserve balance sheet. It goes back to 2007, back when the Federal Reserve balance sheet was relatively stable. And by stable, I mean it was at about $800 billion. $800 billion, the balance sheet of the Federal Reserve. I want you to watch on the chart as we go out through these stable times. Well, right up until the balance sheet triples in 2008. Now, when we're trying to promote economic stability, the tripling of any government balance sheet should be of concern. Federal Reserve balance sheet triples in 2008. I hold in my hand, Mr. Speaker, a hearing from my very first month on the Budget Committee. That first month occurred 3 years ago. It was 2011, and Chairman Paul Ryan was questioning Ben Bernanke, then the Federal Reserve Chairman. And Chairman Ryan said, I want to talk to you about QE2, quantitative easing 2, and what it is doing to the American economy. And Chairman Bernanke's response was this, Mr. Speaker. He said, what we are doing here is a temporary measure which will be reversed so that at the end of this process, the money supply will be normalized, the amount of the Fed's balance sheet will be normalized, and there will be no permanent increase either in money outstanding or in the Fed's balance sheet, or in inflation. February 2011. I point to February 2011 on my chart here, Mr. Speaker, where the Federal Reserve Chairman said that the balance sheet would begin to normalize. And what I want you to observe is that in the intervening months between February 2011, when normalization was discussed and projected, we've actually seen the balance sheet increase almost 100%. Today we're met with the news that a return to a normalized balance sheet may be delayed even further. Mr. Speaker, these are decisions on which no member of this chamber votes. These are decisions on which no member of America's Board of Directors, being the American voters, have a voice. And this is a decision that will either rescue or destroy the economic future of this country. It needs to be discussed more often, Mr. Speaker. I intend to bring these issues to the floor on a regular basis. No harm will come from shining the bright light of transparency on these Federal Reserve decisions. No harm will come by incorporating 330 million Americans into this debate about America's economic security. With that, I yield back the balance of my time.
The gentleman yields back the balance.